The following is a non-profit, fan-based parody. My Little Pony, Friendship is Magic is property of Hasbro Studios, Inc. and DHX Media. Please support the official release.
You want to try running that by me again?
Now what about this ain't you get?
What I ain't getting is the thought process behind that brain of yours. Were you even thinking?
Of course I was thinking.
Then why the hell would you let Apple experiment on you?
Oh, come on, big brother. Y'all want our contract to go through or not?
I do, but there are times when you just gotta say no.
Oh, you're one to talk, Mr. Too Wrecked to Work. Who would've guessed Cheerilee was so kinky?
Damn it, Applejack, this ain't a joke. Letting some pony abuse your body ain't the same as letting them abuse your mind. And frankly, I don't need a lecture from the runt of the family.
I ain't no runt. Apple Bloom ain't even got her cutie mark yet.
Oop, sorry.
First of all, she's twice as big as you were at her age. And secondly, Apple Bloom is special. She ain't gonna be damned to a life of farming like you and I. And as soon as we stop hindering her and let her go out on her own, not only will she earn her cutie mark, but I bet she'll be the best at her calling there ever was. It's a shame she's too young to help me instead.
What the hell does that mean?
Face it, Applejack. I love you and all, but you're not any good at what we do. You and I both know that I'm just gonna end up doing most of the harvesting myself, injury or not.
You son of a bitch. I can pull my weight just as well as you can. Why? I'll harvest the whole orchard all by myself!
Why are you yelling?
Because I can't hear myself think over this damn music!
What music?
Never mind. The point is, I'm gonna get these here apples harvested without your help by next week, or my name ain't Applejack Felicity Smith.
Whatever you say, I'm willing to see how this plays out.
Yeah, I can do this. No sweat. Ooh.
Alright, you're hearing music. Just music, that's all. Music that you can't control. Music that won't stop playing.
Music that you're not gonna let drive you insane! Ow! Damn it!
We will not sit idly by while these cretins muscle us out of our home!
They're stronger than us and impervious to magic!
That may be so.
And?
And what?
That may be so, but...
But what?
Oh my god.
Check it out! Yeehaw! Let's do this! Stop right there, cows! Hey, do I look like I'm playing? Winona! Ha ha! Gotcha! How do you like that, you bovine motherfuckers? Well, seems what we've got here is a failure to communicate. One of you shit stains want to try explaining what y'all were doing off the reservation?
You pony fucks won't keep us down forever!
And after all that trouble we went through to build y'all a nice area to live, this is the thanks we get?
This land was our home long before you cocksuckers settled here! Before your godforsaken princess stole it from us!
Well, now it's ours, and I'm running the show here. Now get on back to your homes. Pray hard enough, and maybe I'll go easy on your revolution-starting hides.
One day you'll pay. This land will run red with pony blood.
But tonight it'll be stained with yours.
Oh, fuck yourself!
Handle threat neutralized.
A true equestrian hero!
Applejack is always so good about keeping those cow monsters in line and whipping the piss out of their rebellion leaders. We should give her an award or something for her efforts. Perhaps I should organize a town meeting? We all
ready? Just one last thing!
Sweet. You Ponyville hicks sure know how to throw some kick-ass block parties.
It's basically all we do.
Is what's her name here yet?
Actually, I haven't seen her all week.
Not since the attack!
I know she'll be here, though. She's probably just busy keeping those stupid bovine in line.
My future subjects. While this gathering is being held primarily in honor of Applejack, it is still a town meeting, and we'll be addressing issues brought up by the community. First off, I am still having problems with intruders invading my home. Now, I've put together a four-step plan that I
Twilight Sparkle, like the council told you last time, it is not your home. It is the town library, and the townsfolk have every right to be there during visiting hours.
That's bullshit! President Celestia said you guys have to accommodate me!
Yes, we are required to accommodate you, not cater to your every whim. The Golden Oak was a library long before you came here, and it will remain as such during and after your banishment to Ponyville.
That's not fair!
It's completely fair! The citizens of Ponyville aren't going to suffer while you're being punished. And as far as I'm concerned, from 9:30 a.m. to 8 p.m., the library is still a library. If some pony comes in without your permission before or after those hours, then, and only then, may you call the authorities on them. Do you understand?
But... my home!
It's not your home!
Just... okay. I'm sure somewhere in here I've got a great reason
why... Twilight Sparkle, get off my stage!
Or what?
Or you will be forcefully removed from the meeting.
You can't remove me!
Try me.
Fuck this!
And so, without further ado, it is my privilege to give the prize pony of Ponyville Award to our glorious protector, a pony who has protected us from the bovine threat countless times, a pony with unwavering courage, tenacity, and hatred for all things cattle, Applejack!
Applejack!
excuse me for just a moment.
Oh,
a word, please.
Shut up, Spike.
Ma'am?
You let me go on and she's not even here? You let me make a fool out of myself in front of everyone!
But, Mayor, I didn't...
Shut up! Don't fucking talk! And don't fucking look at me! Look at the ground! You're fired!
But...
fired! God, I thought after the Nightmare Moon incident, things would be fixed.
Hold on, I'm here. Don't... just... I'm on my way.
Hey, you stepped on my kid!
Bitch, you can see I'm walking! Get out of the fucking way!
Okay. Well, thanks, I guess, for upholding you and your town's ass-backward ways of oppression. Or whatever.
Well, I like beating the cows. Ooh, and stuff. Yeah, so, thanks.
That was weird. What the hell's her problem?
Huh? What?
Applejack's fine, dear. What the hell are you talking about? I barely have a reason to care, and even I notice something's wrong.
Twilight, AJ's a grown mare. Even if there is something wrong, she can take care of it.
Well, this looks about how I imagined Apple's working.
We're kicking off another 6-hour commercial-free rock block with Nirvana's Drain You. Oh, kick ass. Other song.
Maybe she is okay? One baby, two. Maybe not. Hey, Applejack!
sleeping loser says what?
Wake up, asshole, Jack!
God damn it.
Applejack!
Howdy, Twilight.
So, are you alright?
Oh, yeah. Why?
Whoa. It's just, the girls were concerned.
That's weird. Doesn't sound like the gals I know.
Okay, I was concerned.
Really? Why?
I don't know. You're acting strange.
How the hell would you know? You barely even talk to me.
Because only an idiot wouldn't see that there's something going on with you.
It still doesn't answer why you of all ponies would care. From what I understand, you don't even like me.
Yeah, I don't. Shut up. I just don't want one of my hench ponies hurt if we need to take care of some business, that's all.
Well, why don't you take a page from the other girls' books and worry about yourself? We all have our own little hiccups and stumbles from time to time, and it's up to us to take care of them ourselves. Like when one of Fluttershy's animals dies, or Dash's coke problem.
Rainbow does cocaine?
When she was in the Wonder Vaults, I'm pretty sure it was a regular thing for her. But you know what? We all left her alone, and eventually she worked it out by herself.
But that's not a good way to deal with things. What the hell is wrong with you ponies?
Oh, like you have any room to talk. You're always abusing Spike, and I ain't once ever called protective services on you.
Motherfucker, I've never abused Spike.
Well, you and him talk about it a lot, for it to have never happened.
I can explain that.
Mm-hmm.
No, I can. Check it out. Okay. Once upon a time, Mistress Celestia gave me a little brother, Spike. Things were pretty great for a while, until one day it came to my attention that he had become an ornery little shit. This went on for many, many years. Until one day we found that we had exhausted all means of pissing each other off.
You're talking an awful lot about yourself for some pony who came here wanting to help me.
Applejack, don't interrupt! Like I was saying, we were running out of ways to push each other's buttons. Until one day, I had an epiphany. Spike hates being ignored. That's when I came up with the ingenious idea to pretend he spoke another language. It was awesome! I never stopped pretending to not understand him, especially around other ponies. Things were great, but then he started acting like I was a big, mean sister. Like I beat him up on a regular basis or something. That old bastard knows I would never do anything to hurt him intentionally. So now I didn't know what to do. Eventually, I decided there's no way I'm gonna let him have this. So I started acting like the cruel mare he wanted. I started referring to him as my slave and threatening him and all that junk. As time went on, our little standoff grew and grew until eventually it became what you see now.
Aren't you guys worried that if y'all keep playing this stupid game of yours, one day DHS or someone will intervene and take him back to your parents, I guess? Who does he even belong to?
Applejack, please. I've already accepted that as an inevitability.
Then why don't y'all grow up and knock it off?
And let him win? Screw that! I'll stop when he does! Now stop trying to make this about me! This is about you! I don't know what's wrong with you, but you clearly can't handle whatever it is on your own.
There ain't nothing wrong with me. And even if there was, you're the last mare I'd come to for help, Twilight Sparkle. So why don't you leave me alone?
Fine, I will.
Thank you. Now, if you need my help with one of your schemes, then you can bother me. Until then, get lost.
There you are.
Ooh, sorry. I was talking to Twilight and she started talking about beating up Spike or something. I don't remember. Somehow the scene ran longer than it normally does. Then I had less time than I thought I did. And all of a sudden, I was late. Now, what are you needing help with?
See that contraption?
Yep. Did you build that?
Duh, dude. What, you think those are in high demand or something?
So, got a lot of free time since you're not in the Wonder Bowl?
Shut up! It's not my fault Weather Patrol takes literally seconds to do. As someone that now works a government job, I can assure you that our tax bits are completely fucking wasted.
Yippee. That's always a pleasure to hear.
Anyways, I'm gonna stand on that platform. Then, you're gonna jump down on the other end, launching me into the air faster than I can take off on my own. I think. I'm not positive. But maybe I'll be able to use that to think up some new tricks.
I'm not gonna lie, Dash. That's fucking stupid.
You're stupid! Just get to jumping!
Well, alrighty then. Oh, hold on. Won't jumping from a two-story platform hurt me?
Come on! Don't be a bitch, bitch!
I ain't no bitch! Poof!
That was close. Try again.
Got it.
Applejack, dude, you suck at this. I'm just gonna go get Pinkie Pie.
No, I got a better idea.
Ta-da! Now here comes the good part.
Oh, I suck. You couldn't even take a 5-foot fall, you pud. Get ready, bitch.
Wait, I'm sorry!
Yeah, let's see how you like falling on your ass.
Well, you're here early.
What?
Sorry, I thought I fell asleep again.
Twilight, please. I'm in a lot of pain. I think my ribs are broken.
Sweet! Never fear, Dash. I'll take care of you.
No, you need to take me to the hospital.
Well, you're no fun. Applejack, there you are!
Well, look who came crawling back. Ready to apologize?
No, I'm not. Ugh. Because of you, Rainbow has 5 broken ribs and a pierced lung.
Me? I never laid a hoof on her!
That's not what I mean! That stupid machine you helped her with yesterday. You got her seriously injured.
She was the one that built it. She's hurt because she's dumb.
I'm not gonna deny that she's dumb, but if you had been in your right mind, you never would have helped her, and this wouldn't have happened. It's your fault!
That's retarded. I ain't no full sitter. It ain't my responsibility to keep her safe.
Dash and I were talking yesterday, and I mentioned that I had talked to you while you were harvesting the day before, and she said that that was unheard of. Normally, you're in charge of chores and making bootleg Apple products.
Listen here, Sparkle. You better stop talking about any of those products allegedly made here and mind your own fucking business.
Oh my god, is that it? Are you finally getting sued by Apple?
Get lost, Twilight. You've worn out your welcome quite enough for one. Ow! Now, if you'll excuse me, I've gotta go help Pinkie Pie.
All right, sweetie. This is your last chance before we leave. You're absolutely positive you don't want us to help you with your CPE bake sale?
No, ma'am! You guys enjoy your afternoon off. I've got Applejack here to help me out.
Yeah. Pinkie Pie, what's wrong with your friend?
Nothing, Dad. She just talks funny because she's a member of the Apple family.
Okay, that's not what I meant, but all right. You know, honey, this bake thing is a, big responsibility, and then we're not going to be mad if you want to take all the credit and, not associate Sugar Cube Corner with it?
Carrot! What your father means is we're very proud of you, Pinky, and we know you do an excellent job. And you are feeling okay, right, Applejack?
Oh, yeah, I'm fine, I think. I got stuck on some weird bubblegum pop station, and now I'm not really sure if I'm sick with rage or about to pass out from joy. Honestly, I guess I don't know how I feel.
All right. See you later, girls! We are going to have a blast! Alrighty, I'll get the sugar and the eggs. Can you get me some chocolate chips?
Hey, what was that?
Next song!
Oh, I'm in no condition for this shit. Maybe if I just give her random ingredients, she'll realize they hadn't let me leave. How about we add in some pop, too?
Sounds good!
Really? Are you even listening?
A cup of flour.
I'll take that as a no. How about some lemon juice instead? That do anything for you?
One last thing. Wheat germ.
Jesus. Alright, I'll put in something you can't ignore.
Now that's gonna be delicious!
Pinky, I put worms in there! Pinky? Do you have ADHD or something? Look at the bowl, Pinky! Pay attention!
Jesus Muffin Spectacular!
Oh, that awesome. Looks good. It looks real good.
Yeah, it smells delicious. Good.
Don't eat the muffins. I put worms in them. Stupid.
You let Apple experiment on you?
What? No! How do you know?
I just finished talking to your brother.
God damn it, just once I wish he could keep his big mouth shut.
What did they do to you?
Nothing I can't handle. Nothing it's any of your concern, Twilight.
It is my concern! You know why? 12. 12 ponies, including Pinky, hospitalized after eating those muffins you helped her bake.
And I care why?
You don't care! That's the problem! Pinkie Pie told me that looking back, now she thinks that you tampered with the recipe on purpose.
Well, I guess some part of her brain was paying attention then.
So you admit it! What did Apple do to you that would make you want to intentionally hurt your friend?
You want to know so bad? Fine. I agreed to help test a new product of theirs that allows you to listen to your music completely hoofs-free. It's a little chip, and it's like an iPod in your head. It even scans your brainwaves and finds new music for you. Plus, it can pick music based off of your mood and taste and all sorts of stuff. Only problem is they've got to beta test it pretty extensively, which means there's a lot of data they need to gather. It's not functioning completely the way it's supposed to yet, and that's what I'm here to help with.
Why would you volunteer for this?
Because I don't have a choice, okay? You were right, Twilight. We shouldn't have been selling bootleg Apple products. I found out, and they came to me with a huge lawsuit. Granny, Big Mac, Apple Bloom, they don't even know about it. All they know is that I agreed to be Apple's dummy for a month. It was either that or lose our home.
Why would you not tell them?
I'm a grown mare, Twilight. This ain't nothing I can't handle on my own. And they don't need to be worrying anyways. It was my decision to sell things that don't belong to me, and now I'm gonna have to be the one to make it better. And hey, once this is over, they're even gonna license our farm to sell their stuff. It's win-win.
Big Mac also told me that you said you'd harvest all these fields because he was injured. You guys aren't on a schedule or anything. Why would you want to make a bet with him in the middle of all this?
You just don't understand.
Of course I don't fucking understand! Explain it!
I've got to do this, Twilight. That's it. It ain't nothing I can't handle. Harvesting an ungodly amount of apples? Nothing to it. Enduring a month of non-stop music that seems to get a bit louder every day? Piece of cake.
Alright, fine. You have no choice, I'll give you that. But at least let me take a look at it! Maybe I could find a way to make it easier on you? I bet I could turn down the volume. Or maybe I could mute it! That'd be perfect! They'd get their data, and if it wasn't right, they'd just chalk it up to the machine being in the experimental phase. We turn the volume back up right before they come back to get it, and boom! They'll never even know I touched it! How's that sound?
I ain't gonna cheat the system! This is my mess, and I'm gonna take care of it! Listen here, I won't suffer, be broken, get tired, or wasted, surrender to nothing,
or give up what I... Applejack! You're not even talking to me! You're just saying what you're hearing! This experiment is clearly taking a toll on you. Just think about what you did to Dash and Pinky, your friends. It's not like you to be so mean.
Like you have any right to call me mean? Ever since you've come to this town, all you've done is be an unpleasant bitch to every pony around you.
Jesus Christ, I'm trying to help you! What the fuck is your problem?
My problem is you're here riding my ass like you have any room to fucking speak, and all I'm trying to do is provide for my fucking family, something you clearly know nothing about!
Hey!
Oh, don't try and act like you give a damn about any pony but yourself! I don't know what you're trying to accomplish right now, but I do know that you don't give a shit about me, or Pinkie Pie, or Rainbow Dash, or Rarity and Fluttershy.
That's not true.
Really? Because we've tried to be friendly with you. For 3 months we tried to be kind to you, and the only time you ever even interact with us is when you've got some stupid plan you need our help with that almost always only benefits you.
You guys never even invite me to go do stuff with you.
The invitation was always open. Maybe if you pull your head out of your ass and stopped by to chat every once in a while, you would have realized that.
I didn't know.
Well, it doesn't matter now! Because I'm starting to think that maybe trying to befriend you was a mistake in the first place! Now, why don't you get the hell off my farm? Go back to your library and brood until your banishment is over, you socially retarded freak.
You're an asshole. I hope that machine rots your fucking brain.
My last talk with Twilight was 3 days ago. Since then, I begged, pleaded, bargained, hoped for a sign that what she said wasn't true. Waited for something, anything to reassure me that I was still in control of the situation. Then, earlier today, Fluttershy came to me for help. She wanted me to help her gather up her bunnies so she could take a new population census. An easy task, one that I've helped her with before. But I don't know what happened. I guess I was irritable. It was so hard to think.
I couldn't even help her wrangle a few measly rabbits. I don't know what's wrong with me. I feel like I'm losing my mind. Like there's a gnawing, relentless ache in my brain, and it won't go away. It hasn't even been 2 weeks yet. I don't know what to do. I keep hoping that something's gonna come to me, but nothing's happening. I can't keep going like this. I just want it to stop. I have an idea. A way to make the pain go away. A solution. A solution I think could work, but it doesn't seem right. But I don't know what else to do. This is the only thing that makes sense.
This next song was requested by Applejack's Brain, with the message, don't do it, you've got so much to live for. Alright.
Alright, Applejack. Enough is enough. I have had it with... Oh my god!
Twilight! What are you doing here?
Applejack! Applejack, it's alright. Everything's gonna be alright. Just put that down and come here.
I don't know what to do, Twilight. I can't get it out of my head and I don't know what to do.
So you're gonna kill yourself?
I don't know what to do.
Then let me help you, you fucking psycho.
I still don't understand. Why do you want to help me?
Because I like you, you dumb hick. Is that what you need to hear? I like you. I like you, and I like the rest of the girls too.
You're just saying that.
No! Okay, maybe I did just see you guys as tools when I first moved here, but since then I really felt like I've gotten to know you guys. I know that doesn't seem possible to you because all we've done together is kooky schemes, but I don't know. I'm sorry I haven't hung out with you guys more. I don't know what to say. I've never had friends before. I don't really know what I'm supposed to do with you guys. And the only reason I'm being so open and telling you this is so you'll be honest with me and admit that you need help.
I need help.
Not like that. It's not supposed to be a punishment. It's supposed to make you feel better. It's not healthy to keep this shit bottled up. If you say it, I promise you'll feel better.
All right. I can't handle this on my own. I can't handle having this machine in my head, and I can't handle harvesting all these apples. I need some pony to help me with it.
And that's all right. There's nothing wrong with needing help.
Yeah. There's nothing wrong with it.
See? Now don't you feel better?
Yeah. You know what? I actually kinda do. Fuck, what was I thinking?
You weren't! You couldn't.
This ain't a solution. This would have only made things worse.
You see how upset I got? Just imagine how the rest of the girls would have felt. Or your family.
I'm sorry I called you a freak. And I'm sorry for trying to drop you off that cliff.
It's okay. I'm sorry I called you a hick all those... Wait, cliff? Are you telling me you didn't know Rainbow and Fluttershy were gonna catch me?
I'm pretty sure somewhere deep down I knew that they would. I just wasn't positive.
You bitch! Ugh, whatever. I guess we're even now. Let's go take a look at this thing.
I'm also sorry about trying to feed you them poison apples.
God damn it! I forgot about that!